हेलो माय डियर फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम बैक अगेन टू आवर यूट्यूब चैनल इनविजिबल थ्रेड्स। होप ऑल ऑफ यू आर डूइंग वेल, कीपिंग योर सेल्फ सेफ एंड मेंटेनिंग ऑल द कोविड प्रोटोकॉल्स। सो टुडे इन दिस वीडियो आई विल मेक ए डिस्कशन ऑन द टॉपिक कॉल्ड फोनोन स्कैटरिंग। सो विदाउट एनी फर्दर डिले लेट्स बिगिन। सो आवर फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन विल बी लाइक, व्हाट इज फोनोन? मे बी सम ऑफ यू हैव सम आइडिया, बट लेट मी डिस्कस ऑन इट ए लिटिल बिट अगेन। So, in solid-state physics, phonon is said to be the quantized mode of vibration occurring in solid crystal lattice. They are massless quantum mechanical particles having some classical analog. The energy and momenta of the photon are quantized. So, we can write it like E phonon is equal to h Vs divided by lambda, where Vs is the speed of the phonon waves in the medium. P phonon is equal to h by lambda, where h is called the Planck's constant. Lambda is the wavelength of the phonon, and lambda phonon is of the order of 10 to the minus of 10 meter. So quantum mechanically, the phonon energy are quantized, as its movement can be taken as a simple harmonic oscillator of classical frequency omega. So we can see that quantum mechanically, like the energy of the phonon can be written like En is equal to n plus half h cross omega, where n is equal to 0, 1, 2, 3, like this. The study of the phonon plays an important role while discussing the thermal conductivity of the material. So we can see from the equation JV is equal to minus of K dT dS, where K is called the thermal conductivity of the material, and JV is called the flux of the thermal energy, or the energy transmitted across unit area per unit time. In the insulating materials, phonons are said to be the primary mechanism which helps to conduct heat in such material in the absence of any electron. So as we have already discussed that phonons are the quantum mechanical version of a special type of vibrational motion, and the special type of vibrational motion that is called the normal modes of vibration. The atoms make small displacement from their equilibrium position, where we assume the minimum of the band potentials are like a parabola, and the forces between the atoms can be described as a linear spring. So we can see from here that this is the approximation, the parabolic approximation of the potential. So this is the potential energy, this is the displacement from the equilibrium. So you can see this is the harmonic approximation, this curve, this is the exact one, and this is called the third order approximation. So the third order comes from the anharmonic perturbation. So you can see this is the initial position and the atoms are displaced, and the atoms, it is assumed that the atoms are connected by a massless spring. So there is equilibrium when they are displaced from the equilibrium position, so they tend to come back from their to their original position. And now, what is this normal modes of vibration? It is the pattern of the modes in which all parts of the system moves with a fixed frequency and a fixed phase-space relation. Any arbitrary vibration in lattice can be considered as a superposition of normal modes with various frequency. So normal modes are called the elementary vibration in lattice. Such kind of vibration has some wave-like property in classical mechanics, but they also have the particle-like property when the lattice is analyzed by the quantum mechanics. Now the phonons are quasi-particles of the boson type. They follow the Bose-Einstein statistics. So what is the boson? Boson is a kind of particle that has quantum mechanical obstruction to occupy the same state which the fermions do not have. Now, when the phonon moves through the crystal lattice, they can scatter through several mechanisms. So what is the different kind of mechanisms? You can see from here. So this is the first one, is the phonon impurity scattering. The next one is the Umklapp phonon scattering. The third one is the phonon boundary scattering. And the last one is the phonon electron scattering. All the kind of scattering process are characterized by the relaxation rate 1 by tau, which is the inverse of the relaxation time. At first, we will discuss on the phonon impurity scattering. So this is the phonon impurity scattering. So the scattering of the waves is due to the inhomogeneity of the medium, and same thing happens for the thermal phonons too. There may be randomly distributed particles that may cause phonon localization via multiple scattering, and the interference of the phonon waves can also occur. The interaction may be elastic or the non-elastic, and the characteristics of the interaction depends on the size of the scattering center. If the scattering is elastic, it may fall into three different regimes. So if the scattering is elastic, we can write it like, first one is a Rayleigh scattering, where d is very very less than lambda. So what is d? D is the diameter of the scattering center, and lambda is the wavelength of the phonon. The next one is a Mie scattering, where d is comparable to lambda. And the third one is a geometrical scattering, where d is very very greater than lambda. It means the diameter of the scattering center is very very greater than the wavelength of the phonon. The point defect possesses a minimum size of scattering center in the solid, and wavelength of the thermal phonon is many times larger than the lattice spacing. So through the Rayleigh scattering, we get very weak scattering length. It happens for very low frequency and for the high lambda of phonon. You can see the point defect is very small, the phonon wavelength is large. So for the high low frequency or the high lambda, the Rayleigh regimes occur. So we can see that the Rayleigh scattering is the main mechanism of loss in optical fiber. This happens if in the crystal the metallic ion impurities like aluminium 3+, sodium plus, lithium plus, or like selenium 4+ are randomly distributed. Now Rayleigh scattering mode results in the typical omega to the power 4 dependence for the phonon vacancy scattering rate. So we can see the phonon vacancy scattering rate is proportional to omega to the power 4. So now in another scenario, the correct distribution or the thermal conductivity of the solid requires scattering of the phonon in the Mie regime. For simple geometry like cylindrical or the spherical shape of the embedded particle, it is easy to get the exact solution for the elastic wave scattering in the Mie regime. If the impurity is a charged one, it must polarize its surrounding with the effective charge of Zd by Ks. This is the effective charge, where Z is a charge number and Ks is a medium dielectric constant. So Zd is a charge number and the Ks is a medium dielectric constant. Now from the Frohlich interaction, which occurs in the polar semiconductor, where the longitudinal optical phonons produced a macroscopic electric field of the long range coupling, and it interacts coulombically with the charge and anharmonically with the surrounding polarization. So from the Frohlich interaction we can get, of the second order Frohlich interaction, we can get that the scattering rate is proportional to 1 by VL square QQ, where VL is the phonon velocity, Q is the phonon wave vector. For the smaller wave vector, you can see if the Q is small, the scattering rate is higher. In the case of the alloy atom with the size of 1 angstrom, the short wavelength or the large frequency phonons are scattered due to the geometrical scattering. Inclusion of the nanoparticle in alloy changes the thermal conductivity significantly due to the different scattering process. Now we will discuss on the Umklapp phonon-phonon scattering. So our next page shows Umklapp phonon-phonon scattering. So in the harmonic theory of the lattice vibration, we assume that the two lattice waves do not interact. The second one is the no thermal expansion or the heat transfer. The adiabatic and the isothermal elastic constant are equal and they are independent of the temperature and the pressure. Heat capacity is constant at the high temperature. But normally, no such implications are observed, and that leads to the anharmonic approximation, causing phonon-phonon recombination process. So now you can see the two figures here. This is the phonon collision in the two-dimensional square lattice. So you can see from the figure that this is the kx axis, this is the ky axis, this is for the incident two phonon k1 and k2, and this is the scattered one, this is the k3. So if this relation holds, that k1 plus k2 is equal to k3, we can call it like normal process or the n process. And in another one, this k1 plus k2 is not equal to k3, so we need some another vector. This is called the g vector. This is the reciprocal lattice vector. So now the phonon mean free path can be determined by the geometrical scattering or the scattering by the other phonon. So we can consider here three phonon process, like I have already discussed. This is the k1 plus k2 is equal to k3. Here the system of three phonons do not establish equilibrium, but if we consider the total phonon gas, the momentum will not change for the total system. The equilibrium distribution of the phonon at any temperature T can move down the crystal with a drift velocity which is not unhampered by such three phonon collision. So we can see that in for some one process the momentum change is nh nk h cross k, but if I consider the total momentum change, it is zero. The most important three phonon process that helps to understand the thermal resistivity is of the form of k3 plus g is equal to k1 plus k2, or mainly the Umclap process is responsible for such phonon scattering. So now in this state you can see this is the g is called the reciprocal lattice vector, and the process is called the Umclap process. When the g is zero, it is considered as the normal process. This tells us that meaningful phonons, if the k vector lies in the first believing zone, so whereas any k vector is introduced in the collision, that must be brought in the first zone by addition of the g vector. So after the collision, if such any k vector is produced that it is outside of the first believing zone, with the addition of the g vector, which is the reciprocal lattice vector, we can bring back the k vector in the first zone. At the high temperature, where the kBT is very greater than the h cross omega max, we can write that at the high temperature, the Umclap process dominates, where the kBT greater than h cross omega max, and k1, k2 must be of the order of half g, because we have the relation in the Umclap process that k1 plus k2 is equal to k3 plus g. So in the right hand side there is g, so in the left hand side must be k1 and k2 greater than or equal to half g, in order to make possible the collision process. If the phonon have the low energy or the low k vector, then the collision is impossible. So our next topic of discussion will be phonon boundary scattering. This type of scattering occurs for low dimensional nanostructures. So where the characteristic length means like the film thickness or the wire diameter is comparable to the phonon mean free path, and we can write it like L very very less than lambda b. As the phonon transport is dominated by the scattering, the conductivity becomes the size independent. So we can make the ratio, this is the conductivity of the free path and this is for the bulk, the kf by kb, we can write it like lambda f by lambda b. So this is for the bulk, this is for the mean free path and this is for the bulk mean free path. So it is equal to 1 by kn, and kn is called the Knudsen number. Kn is defined as lambda b over L. So from the study it is known that the local thermal conductivity is half of the bulk value when the Knudsen number, this kn, is very small. So you can see this is the phonon diffusive scattering, this is the incident phonon, this is the interface, this is the reflected part of the phonon and this is the transmitted part. From this figure we can see that the diffusive scattering happens when phonons are reflected by a boundary having surface roughness comparable or higher than phonon wavelength. So this is our last type of scattering process, electron phonon scattering. So this is the dominant temperature dependent scattering mechanism. Basically it is of two types. One is the deformation potential interaction, and this is the non-polar type, and another one is the polar interaction. So the deformation potential interaction occurs due to the displacement of the ionic potential, which has the effect on the electronic energy. And the displacement occurs due to the generation of the both acoustical and the optical phonon waves. And in another part, the polar interaction occurs because of the optical phonons that causes a long-range dipole field, and electrons are scattered by this field and electrons are oscillating. So now we can write the Hamiltonian describing the electron phonon system as the total Hamiltonian is the Hamiltonian for the electronic part, Hamiltonian for the phononic part, the Hamiltonian for the Coulombic interaction, and the Hamiltonian for the electron phonon interaction. So where we can write the electron phonon Hamiltonian as constant divided by V times A0 cube, where A0 is the lattice constant and V is called the density of states, integration of d cube x, a dagger x, ax times divergence of ux, where ux is the displacement of the atoms, and the charged atoms per unit cell is the z times divergence of ux, where z is the charge of the single ion. So now we can write the displacement of the phonon creation and the displacement ux in terms of the phonon creation at the and the annihilation operator, because the when the atom displaced in the phonon wave will generated, and the when the atom will get back to its initial position, the phonon is annihilated. So now we can write it that the in the phonon creation and the annihilation operator, we can write it like bq and bq prime dagger. The commutation of bq and bq prime dagger, we can write it like 2 pi times delta function of q minus q prime, and where the phonon angular frequency omega q is equal to c times the magnitude of the q vector, the wave vector. So from these two we can write the Hamiltonian for the electron phononic part as g times d cube x a dagger x ax times the phi x, where the phi x is the electron wave function in terms of phonon annihilation and the creation operator, and this g is called the interaction constant. Now from including all such scattering mechanism, we can write that from the Mathiasian rule, the combined relaxation time of all such scattering processes, this is the tau c. So we can write it like 1 by tau c is equal to 1 over tau u plus 1 over tau m plus 1 over tau b plus 1 over tau of electron phononic, where u is for the umklapp phonon-phonon interaction, thus m is for the mass difference impurity or the impurity phonon interaction, the b is for the phonon boundary interaction or the scattering mechanism, and e phonon is for the electron phonon interaction. So my friends, I'm concluding my today's discussion here. Please do like, share and subscribe our channel Invisible Threads, and press the bell button also for new updates every time. See you all in my next video. Stay safe and thank you.